Everyone and welcome back to my channel. Myself Dr. Surbhi Sahni. Hope you are doing great. This is a very pending request which is coming from your side. That is, what is the scope of BDS, like after BDS in Australia, and that too in 2023? Because that is another what after BDS option, as if you are thinking of taking a drop and then you want to explore the other options, or you have done a lot of practice in India and you want to explore and go outside India, then this is one of the best option. So let's talk about what after BDS in Australia in 2023. What are the steps? What are the university? What will be the scope? So definitely the video will come in parts, not too lengthy but not too short. So it's my humble request that if you are new on my channel, do subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. The importance of bell icon is that you can have the notification of my upcoming video. Moreover, watch this video till the end. That is my another humble request. Now, to practice our dentistry in Australia, and that too in 2023, you need to clear the ADC exam. That is a mandatory thing which you need to be clear. Now, there are certain steps which you need to follow or to perform so as you can practice the dentistry in Australia in 2023. First one is the assess your qualifications. Before anything else, you need to go through the assessment of your qualification, that too into the Australian Dental Council, that is the ADC. It is necessary to determine whether your qualification is up to the mark or whether your BDS degree is equivalent to the Australian dental degree or not. This is the first step. Second is the English language proficiency. You need to ensure and meet the requirements that the English language proficiency should be there. It is mandatory. And for that, you need to either give the exam of IELTS or TOEFL, that is TOEFL examination is mandatory. The test is there, you need to give that and achieve a good marks, right? Followed by the third step is you need to register yourself with the AHPRA. Now, what is AHPRA? If your qualification are recognized and it is up to the mark according to the Australian Dental Council, then you will need to apply for the registration with the Australian Health Practitioner Regulation Agency. This is the full form of AHPRA. It is the mandatory step if you want to practice as a dentist in Australia. Now the fourth step is the Overseas Trained Dentist Program. If your qualification directly or indirectly is not up to the mark, right, according to the Australian Dental Council, then you need to complete an Overseas Trained Dentist Program, that is known as the OTDP, that is a bridge gap exam. That is, you can say that it is a bridge to cover up the gap between your degree, your qualification and the Australian Dental Council. Education and training with their education and training. Followed by the fifth step is the Dental Council examination. Dentist may require to pass the ADC preliminary examination followed by the ADC final examination, which is comprising of the comprehensive assessment of the dental knowledge and the skills. Now, what is the sixth step? Sixth step is the professional year. Completing a professional year program is very, very beneficial for you. It is designed to help the international graduates to adapt to the Australian work, place, culture, to adapt with the people, nature, understand, bonding, that is all mandatory in your professional year. Followed by the seventh step is the specialization or the master degree. If you wish to specialize in a particular area or if you want to enhance your qualification, it is required to pursue the master degree in dentistry or in some specification in some particular area, for example, some diploma in dentistry or some diploma in any other branch like health management, health administration and so on. First step is the job search. Start looking for the job in the private sector, in dental clinics, in hospitals or some private practice of your own. Networking and building the professional connection is very, very important in the professional area, and that too in the foreign country like Australia. It helps you to find a job and make you financially stable, and employment is definitely there. Ninth step is you can continue doing your education in Australia. Like, you can stay updated with the latest advancement in your field like dentistry by attending the workshop, classes, seminar or continuing doing the courses with the latest updates and equipments in dentistry. Now the 10th step is the ADA, Australian Dental Association. Consider to become a member of the ADA, that is the Australian Dental Association, which can provide you the valuable sources, networking opportunities and support you in your dental career. So these are the following steps which you can do what after BDS in Australia, and that too in 2023. Followed by the 11th step is the residency. If you plan to settle in Australia permanently, explore the options for obtaining the permanent residency, that is the PR, such as a skilled migration programs. Followed by the long-term goals. You need to set up the long-term goals career, whether you want to settle in Australia and that too in the academic section or in the practice section like private practice, or pursuing some research options, because the research options are also very good in Australia as compared to India. Now remember one thing. Whenever you go and do or pursue some specific step from all of the above steps which I have told you, it depend upon state to state, it depend upon location to location, and it may vary. So definitely it is very, very important for you as a BDS to go through it in deep and in detail, and then you can explore your option at your own risk. Want to pursue dentistry, or you want to switch over to some non-clinical dentistry, some research opportunity or something else in Australia. Essential to do the research and the contact relevant institutions and the authorities for the most accurate and updated informations regarding your particular plan, schedule and situation. So that's all about the steps which will help you to decide what you have to do after BDS in Australia in 2023. Now don't forget to stay tuned with my channel. In my next video, I will definitely come forward to talk about Masters in Public Health Dentistry, and that too in Australia. What are the steps, how you will do that, and what are the complications you can face or follow. So don't forget to stay tuned with my channel. If you still have any query, you can drop me the mail which is shown on your screen. And don't forget to follow me on my Instagram ID which is shown on your screen. Thank you for watching.